Hi, I'm Jacqueline French, professor of neurology at NYU Epilepsy Center and chief medical and innovation officer at the Epilepsy Foundation. And I am here today to give you a whirlwind tour of master protocols. Thanks very much to the NIH for asking me to speak today. These are my disclosures. All of the consulting money that comes in goes to the Epilepsy Study Consortium, which pays for a portion of my salary at NYU. So why don't we keep doing things the way that we're doing them now? The question is the current design of the parallel add-on trial stale? Is it ethical? Because every patient that is enrolled in a study, their participation should be as meaningful as possible. And if there is a way to make it more meaningful by improving the design, then we should be doing that. Could we be doing more efficient trials with fewer patients if we change the design? How much can we learn from every single subject we enroll? Or in other words, can we squeeze more juice out of the clinical trial orange? So one of the ways to consider doing it, among others, is by using a master protocol. So what is a master protocol? It is one trial design that has multiple sub-studies under it. So those sub-studies may have different objectives. They may evaluate one or more drugs. They may include people with one or more diseases, syndromes, or conditions. And there are really three major types of master protocol design that I will very briefly tell you about: the basket trial, the umbrella trial, and the platform trial. So let's start with the umbrella trial. This is probably the one that is of least interest, at least at this very moment in epilepsy. This is a trial that is primarily used in cancer setting, and it is one where a single disease is stratified based on biomarkers. And of course, to use it in epilepsy, we would have to have biomarkers, which currently we don't. And we then would assign people to different therapies based on the biomarker that we see. So it's a single disease. You screen for the presence of the biomarker. And then if they're positive for biomarker one or biomarker two or biomarker three, they would get targeted therapy one, targeted therapy two, or targeted therapy three. So again, hopefully in the future, we will have biomarkers, but at the moment we do not. So let's move on to the platform trial. This is a multi-arm randomized protocol where a patient population with a single disease or condition is enrolled. And basically it is like a parallel trial, but instead of just saying we have one arm of one single drug comparing it to a control arm, we might have multiple drugs that we're using in the same study with a placebo control arm. And once that particular arm ends, we actually take that one out and we can add another one. So we're still always accumulating, let's say in a 3-to-1 or a 4-to-1 fashion, the placebo control arm over time, but we're swapping out the active treatments. So the other arms that are added and removed when they recruit enough subjects to provide the definitive answer for that particular arm. So here in this example, you have three treatments originally, but then you have a future treatment that you swap in. So what is the advantage of a platform trial? It's very efficient because you don't need to enroll a new placebo arm for every trial separately. And that means that each patient has a higher likelihood of being randomized to active treatment, which the patients much prefer, of course, because they don't like to be on a placebo treatment. And it also may be good for orphan populations where few subjects should be put on placebo and every patient is precious. So for example, there are so many trials right now with Dravet syndrome. Every single one has its own placebo arm. That's a lot of wasted patients in the trial. Imagine if you did a platform trial where each of those different therapies was compared to one placebo arm. But of course, there are disadvantages too. It becomes very complex and cumbersome, and you have to ask yourself, how would you exit a subject from the trial without breaking the blind? What would you exit them to? You need an impartial body to run the trial if you're going to be using different drugs from different sponsors. For those reasons, although we've talked about it a lot, has it been tried in epilepsy? Not yet. And finally, we come to the basket trial, where, you know, as you can see this from this beautiful fruit basket, multiple different diseases or syndromes or groups are treated in a single trial. It may or may not have a placebo group, and it may have an otherwise standard design, but you're using multiple different groups. And it may or may not be powered to show benefit to all groups. So let's say your power calculation may be determined based on the group as a whole of 120 subjects, but you're enrolling 40 subjects in each group, and therefore you might not have power in each group to show a difference. And all of them are going to be treated with the same treatment A. So what are the advantages? This is used when you are not yet sure what the ideal population is going to be for your study. So you're testing it out on a number of different groups at the same time. You don't have the burden of starting multiple trials in multiple groups. You can enroll small populations. It can give you a hint for your next larger trial. And a big advantage is it's already been tried in epilepsy. For example, Ovid Takeda is trying TAC-935, which is a new therapeutic intervention. In a pilot study in two studies, Arcade and Electra, Arcade actually enrolled CDKL5 and DUP15Q, whereas Electra enrolled both Dravet syndrome and Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. Then based on those, they can decide which is the best shot on goal to move forward with a more definitive trial. Disadvantage, you may indeed be led down the garden path by a non-statistical trend. Oh, this is looking really good in these 40 subjects. Then you go to the larger study and it's a bust. But certainly if it works and you see a trend that you can believe, it's much more efficient than starting multiple trials. So in summary, I know this has been very quick. I think it's time to try new things in the epilepsy space. There are these new trials emerging, and hopefully more of them will emerge over time and give us more efficient trials and better therapies. Thank you so much.